In this video, I'm going to finish the Infinite Algebra 1 free KutaSoftware website worksheet, Solving System of Equations by Graphing. Picking up where we left off in number 5, we're going to be using slope-intercept form to plot each of the equations, find the intersection, and that intersection will be our answer. So in number 5, for our slope in our first equation, we have 3, and our y-intercept b is going to be a negative 4. Because remember, y equals mx plus b, so this minus 4 we can think of as plus a negative 4. So plotting those points, we'll have 0 and then negative 4 as our y-intercept. And if the slope is 3, remember slope is rise over run. So we can write this as 3 over 1. From our y-intercept, we'll go up 3 in the positive y direction and over 1 in the positive x direction to the point 1, negative 1. Now I'll draw a line to connect those two. Now we'll plot our other line. Our slope in our next line is negative 1 half, and our y-intercept b is equal to 3. So here's negative 1 half, and there is 3. So 0, positive 3, is our y-intercept, and then we'll go down 1 and over 2, so down 1 in the y direction and positive 2 in the x direction to get to the point 2, 2, and we'll draw a line and connect. The intersection of these two equations occurs at the point 2, 2. Therefore, 2, 2 is the solution in number 5. Moving on to number 6, we have a slope of negative 2, so I'm going to write this as negative 2 over positive 1. And our y-intercept b is a positive 2 for our first equation. So 0, 2, plotting the y-intercept, and then I'm going to go down 2 in the y-direction and positive 1 in the x-direction, and then draw a line connecting those two points in order to form a line for our equation. Now, plotting the next line, our slope again is negative 2. So negative 2 over 1, rise over run, and our y-intercept b is a negative 2. So right away, noticing that our lines are the same slope, we know they're going to be parallel. And parallel lines never intersect. So there's going to be no solution. But let's go ahead and plot just so you can see that there is no intersection. So the y-intercept is 0, negative 2, and our slope is negative 2, so negative 2 over 1, going down 2 in the y direction and over 1 in the positive x direction, and then we'll draw a line connecting those two points. So you can see that those lines will never intersect, therefore there is no solution. And number 7, for our first equation, our slope m is negative 1 half, and our y-intercept b is a negative 2. So plotting the y-intercept, 0, negative 2, and then using the slope to find another point on that line, we'll go down 1 in the y direction and over 2 in the positive x direction to get to the point 2, negative 3. Then we'll draw a line and connect. Now, for my next equation, my slope m is negative 3 halves, and my y-intercept b is a positive 2. So plotting 0, 2, and then using that slope to find my next point, I'll go down 3 in the y direction and over 2 in the positive x direction. Negative 3 over 2, and then I'll plot that next point. Now I'll draw a line connecting those points. And you can see my intersection occurs at the point 4, negative 4. So 4, negative 4 is my solution in number 7. And lastly on this worksheet, number 8. If you haven't done so already, go ahead and click that like button, and while you're at it, click that subscribe button as well. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Now in number 8, our first equation, we have a slope m of 1 over 3, rise over run, and our y-intercept b is going to be a negative 3. So plotting 0, negative 3, and then using the slope from that point, we'll find another point on the line. So going up 1 in the positive y direction and over 3 in the positive x direction will be at the point 3, negative 2. Now let's look at our second equation. Y equals negative x or negative 1 times x, so our slope is negative 1, And then plus 1, so our b, our y-intercept, is a positive 1. And we can write our slope negative 1 as negative 1 over positive 1. Rise over run. So plotting 0, 1, our y-intercept, and then going down 1 in the y-direction and over 1 in the positive x-direction. We'll plot our other point and then draw a line to connect. And you can see that our intersection occurs at 3, negative 2. So 3 in the x and negative 2 in the y is our final solution. If you didn't do so before number 8, remember to like, subscribe, and share.